Carr also said the Coast Guard made radio contact with a vessel that identified itself as the Sea Nymph and Junior Tahiti, and the captain said they were not in distress and expected to make land the next morning. That was after the women reportedly lost their engines and sustained damage to their rigging and mast. A retired Coast Guard officer who was responsible for search and rescue operations said that if the women used the emergency beacon, they would have been found. If the thing was operational and it was turned on, a signal should have been received very, very quickly that this vessel was in distress, Phillip R. Johnson said Monday in a telephone interview from Washington State. The women also said they had six forms of communication that all went dead. "There's something wrong there," Johnson said. The Hawaii residents reported that their sailing equipment and engine failed and said they were close to giving up when the U.S. Navy rescued them last week, thousands of miles off course. They were taken to Japan, where they didn't immediately respond to an email and call seeking comment Monday.